Fans, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Dusty, you've been noticeably absent in recent weeks after Ronnie Garvin turned on you.
Well, let me tell you something, Bob Cowell. Let me tell everybody throughout the world what Dusty Rhodes has been doing. What Dusty Rhodes has been doing is very simple. It boils down to Ronnie Garvin and Dusty Rhodes. Head up. Gary Hart comes out here playing the dozen, talking about my family, talking about the people in Macon, Georgia. Day after day, night after night, I see the lines being drawn. Dr. Death, Steve Williams, Nikita Koloff-Stiga, Lex Luger, the Rock and Roll Express, the many great Fantastics now gather in the lines. But most of all, somebody came back to Dusty Rhodes after all these years. My main man now stands with Sting, now stands with Nikita, now stands with us and Doc and all of us and the Road Warriors. And that man, my man, the Outlaw, Dick Murdoch, now is my man, baby. So Gary Hart, if you're listening, I'm gonna leave a wake-up call for you, Daddy. The American Dream gonna leave a wake-up call for you. If I see you anywhere, any place, I'm gonna take it to you. Because Bob Cowell, one thing is for sure, Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, now takes heed and pride in delivering to you, Ronnie Garvin, you, Al Perez, to the Varsity Club, to the Midnight Express, to all of them now, the Husband, a lot of pain, blues, and agony, baby.
Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream. You heard him talk about the man in the ring. Let's go to the ring right now. And here he is, Jim Ross. There's Captain Redneck, Dick Murdoch.
Well, Dick Murdoch has always been a very colorful, controversial figure in the world of professional wrestling. There's not anything in the square circle that he can't do or hasn't done. A very, very accomplished athlete, but what he is above all is he is one of the most physical men ever in the sport of professional wrestling.
And here he is.
So high at the point.